Velkommen til Copenhagen. Floating 85 miles off the coast of Denmark, on Zealand and Amager Islands, the city of Copenhagen was originally settled by the Vikings as a fishing village in the 10th century. Copenhagen translates as Merchant's Harbor, and today has grown into one of the largest seaports in the Baltic Sea, hosting more than 1.6 million visitors and 10 million tons of cargo. You won't find the Copenhageners in longboats now, but you will find them cruising the streets on longboards and bicycles. With citywide programs to keep the harbor waters clean and serene, Copenhagen has been ranked the greenest city in the world by the Global Green Economy Index, with a goal to be completely carbon neutral by 2025. Jacob Hartman, a lifelong aquaculturist, tends to his mussel farms on the edge of the pier. Manning the cargo hold is Emil Hostrup, a young port worker with a bird's eye view of the city.
Call it a divorce job, because you know when you have to come to work, but you don't know when you're going home. You go home and sleep and put on your work clothes and go out here again. There's no like order in which container is for who. You just go under the crane, pick up whatever they give you, and then the screen will tell you where we are going. The company has been creating an education, so we get more education now than we did before. So that's positive. More with safety, and it's changing. So now we have to wear a line when we crawl up in the heights, and that's kind of nice. In the old days, it was not like that. It was just up and don't fall, that's not allowed. Then you get fired because you're dead. So maybe it's a hard, the tone is hard, we talk hard to each other, but it's a kind of love because they want to make sure you have it good and not sad. And you have to have it good. That's rule number one. And everything comes behind that.
I'm from Jutland, but I moved here to work with Greenpeace for many years ago, trying to actually change the European chemical legislation, which was very bad and didn't include all of the chemical substances. The maritime allotments, I stumbled upon it some years ago and thought, wow, how is this for creativity? Well, everyone's talking about creativity and innovation. In Denmark, we have a long tradition for allotments where people can grow their own food above water, on soil, on the land. And suddenly there was this guy that said he wanted to do maritime allotments underwater. I thought, okay, that's a new idea.
These are actually where you start to grow them. And once you have them here, you transfer them into this stocking, and then they can grow here. These are for the larger mussels.
The organization behind these maritime allotments is of course very keen on re-establishing the link between the production and the actual food we eat. The best thing that happens here is when we get the kids down here, because the kids are the future, and if they get the feel of real foods, healthy foods that are produced locally and with a craftsmanship, then I think we're teaching them something very, very important. And I think that's a big part of sustainable development, is that there's more of us working to improve our own town or spaces.
Thank you.
With offshore wind farms and other urban innovations, Copenhagen brings the green economy to its medieval castles and its brightly colored canal district.